Okay, so in 7.1, we're going to look at factoring out the greatest common factor. So that's going to harken us back a little bit to our Math 20, where we first started talking about greatest common factor. The greatest common factor of two or more polynomial terms is the expression containing the greatest common coefficient factor and the greatest common variable factor. The greatest common coefficient factor is found in the exact same way that the greatest common factor of a set of numbers is found. The greatest common variable factor will contain the highest power of each variable that appears in every monomial. So let's translate that into what this means. So if we look at this term and this term, we have two terms, 10x to the third, y to the second. If I write the factors of that, the factors are, and actually this is something I try to tell all my students is like, you know, if you can have some kind of mnemonic device. So where do factors happen? Factors are the small pieces that happen in a factory. So you have a factory, has little tiny pieces, has 2 times 5. We call those prime factors. What comes out of a factory is a product. And the product is an answer to a multiplication. But, you know, if you think about factories produce products, right? And product in math means multiplication. So 2 times 5 is 10. That's the product of those two factors. So factors are really just numbers we multiply together. The prime factors, and what we call this is actually the same thing as a factor tree. The prime factors of 10 are 2 times 5. The factors of x to the third, well, what numbers, what could I multiply together to give me x to the third? Yeah, x times what? Times x. So this expanded notation are really the factors of x to the third. That's what I multiply together to give me x to the third. What could I multiply together to give me x squared? Oh yeah, y squared, that's what I mean. Y times y. So all of this multiplies together to give us 10x to the third, y to the third. So this is the product, the answer to a multiplication, and these are the factors, the numbers you multiply together. So who can tell me then, let's do the next one, 12xy to the fifth. What are the factors? And we might use a factor tree to help us factor 12 into its prime factors. So give me some factors of 12. 3 times 4. 2 times 2. Okay, so far this is equal to 3 times 2 times 2. This is called the prime factor. Factorization of 12. So we've broken it down into its most prime factors. What are the factors of x? Just x. What are the factors of y to the fifth? 5y's times each other, times themselves. So when we're trying to find the GCF, the greatest common factor is going to be all the factors that they have in common. So they both have 2 in common, correct? So since this one only has 1 2, this one has 2 2s, I can only use 1 because that's the number that they both have in common. Since this one doesn't have another 2, that would make it 20 instead of 10, right? I can't only use 1 of the 2s. Now, how many x's do they have in common? Yeah, x to the first power. And then how many y's do they have in common? 2 y's, and we write that as y times y is y squared. So that's how we find their greatest common factor. So here for this expression, now that was a binomial and another binomial. We found the greatest common factor. For this one, this is a, or what did I say? This monomial. the greatest common factor, is a monomial. Here, this is a binomial. We have two terms, right, separated by addition. How come I don't just add 2x and 10 together? Can I? No, because they're not like terms. There we go. Okay, what is the GCF? Can it be factored? So let's factor each one. 2 times x plus, how could you factor 10? Oh, so what's the GCF here? 2. 2. Just 2, because they don't both have an x, right? So we can't use 2x. And if we're going to factor it, factoring out the GCF looks like this. I'm going to take the 2x plus 10. I'm going to divide by 2, bringing the 2 out front. Okay, well, I'm going to divide by 2 by bringing the 2 out front. So it's actually just mentally, just have, this is actually just mental, okay? Mental division. So when I divide 2x by 2, what do I get? X, right? 2x divided by 2 gives me x. When I divide 2 into 10, what do I get? 5. So because, just like if I were to distribute, before we were doing multiply, 2 times x plus 5. Multiply, we distribute. 2x plus 10. Factoring, we divide. Factoring is the opposite. So we're looking for what they have in common and dividing it out. So the GCF is going to go out front. And you can see that if I were to distribute, this could count as my check, right? Because I want to see if I divide them both by 2, what would happen if I multiplied it back? I'm just basically a dog chasing my tail, right? I can go back and forth, factoring, multiplying. It's really the same thing. So this is actually just a mental divide by 2, because really if we divide by 2, we know that this answer down here would just be x plus 5 without the 2 in front. So this is what the idea of factoring is. So let's look on the next page. And let's look at 3a. So we want to find the, and sometimes you can just do it visually, right? You don't have to actually factor it what I was showing you. I'm just showing you how that works. What number would go into 2, 4, and 12 evenly? What's the biggest number that would divide evenly into all of those? 2. So the GCF is going to start with a 2. Now, what is the variable with an exponent that could divide evenly into all of those variable terms? X cubed. Does everybody understand why x cubed divides evenly? Let's test it out. X to the 8th, if you divide that by x cubed, what do you get? So that divided evenly, x to the 5th, right? If you have x to the 4th and you divide that by x to the 3rd, what would you get? Just x, right? What about x to the 3rd? Does that divide evenly into x to the 3rd? What do you get when you divide anything by itself? 1. Okay, now let's look at this group here, b. Are there anything, is there a number that you can think of that's going to go into all of those evenly? 5. GCF equals 5. What about any variables? Why not? Exactly. 20 is a term. It's called a constant term. Why is it called a constant term? Constant term. Anybody know? Have you ever heard that before? Constant term? Has no variable. Exactly. So a constant term is a number that has no variable. It's like, I am not going to change. Okay. The variable is going to change. That 15 is going to change if we plug something in for t. 20 has no variable attached to it. So that's why it's called a constant term. Okay. We'll just do a few more and then you'll be working together. So what about this one? Is there a number that you can think of that is going to go into 2, 3, and 4? Just 1. Okay, so the GCF here, GCF is 1. What about the variable? Can you have a variable? X to the 3rd. And so what are you starting to notice? If they all have a variable in common, how do you decide which exponent to use? The smallest one. So if they all have variables in common, you're always going to pick the variable that has the smallest because you don't want to end up with negative exponents. That is not a goal here, okay? So we want to always be able to, you can see here, these divided in evenly. So is this the same thing as x to the third? Yes. So you guys said the 1 originally, and it's fine to put the 1 in front of the x because 1 times x to the third is still x to the third. I just wanted to point that out. So the coefficient that they all have in common is just 1 divides into everything evenly. Okay, what about this one? GCF here. X, y to the second. Do you guys agree with that? That looks right to you? Because the x to the first is the smallest. And y to the second is the smallest. Okay, let's do this one. We're on a roll. Yes, uh-huh. As long as they all have that variable in common, then you're going to pick the smallest. In this example back here, since 20 did not have a variable, we didn't choose a we left it out. Okay. Okay, what about this one? 12. Does 12 go into 32? 8 does, though. Oh, does 8 go into 60? You could also use the prime factors. You know, if it got tricky here, you could factor the numbers. Do you want to see what that looks like? 6? 6 goes in. Oh, yeah, 6 doesn't go into 32. No. 4 does. Does 4 go into 60? Yes. Okay, let's call it 4. But you guys can correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it is 4. We're looking for the biggest one that goes into all of them, the greatest, right? But it has to divide in evenly. Okay, and then what about anything else? They all have an a in common. What's the smallest exponent? Squared. And b squared. Any questions about that? Mm-hmm. This one only has an x. Yeah, for D. Mm-hmm. That's why x to the first power. Otherwise, if it was squared, yes, we could pick it. Okay, do these ones have anything in common? Yes? We're going to get to that in just a moment, okay? What's the point will come up next. Okay, what about these ones? Do they have anything in common? Just 1. So the GCF equals 1. Okay? So go ahead and find those ones with your group members, and then we'll come back to the question.